Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to one and all for the Option Omega Conference, India's largest retail option traders online conference. It's a great pleasure for the entire community and also for Traders Gurukul to have people registering for this mega conference in large numbers. So yesterday we crossed more than 500 registrations for this event. That clearly shows the kind of trust you have on the brand and the kind of speakers that we have got into the program. My sincere thanks and gratitude to every one of you for being a part of this program today. So we have a very interesting person, my best friend Santosh Pasi, as the first speaker of Option Omega Conference. His topic today would be options adjustments and its real-time applications. And for people who don't know him, he is an option trader. He is also a trainer, and he is a founder of this firm called Pasi Technologies. He has been a market veteran for a long time, and he trades options left and right. He eats, breathes, and lives options. So I would rather request Santosh to speak more about his work and experience. With this, I hand over the stage to Santosh. Santosh, thank you so much for being with us. The stage is yours. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashok. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to be here. I hope you guys are able to hear me, although it's raining in Bombay at the moment. Just rain started, okay? So guys, stay safe and let's start over here. So today's topic is options adjustments. In fact, during this pandemic, we are adjusting our lives, correct? So that is the same thing we have to do with the options. So if option trade goes uncontrolled somewhere here and then we have to do the adjustments. And as this is related with the financial market and we do have regulations, so this is my disclosure and disclaimer. So just read that before we move forward, so I won't be responsible for anything goes wrong, okay? So let's move forward. And here is my short introductions. As Ashok said, I'm actually into I hold two master's degrees, MBA, MCA plus PMP, and I'm actually auditor plus I have a NISM certificates also. At the same time, I'm being in the trading world for more than 14 years, and mostly my focus is non-directional strategies, okay? And so least bother about the direction, but more focus that I should be a non-directional. Let's take the trade, and my focus is mostly to take volatility as my primary factor, and then make your strategies based on the volatility. We do have software known as Option Oracle, and I hope most of you guys are using that. And at the same time, we do have another software, Opstrata, that assists us to plan our strategies and to validate our strategies. We are into trainings also, and we have conducted a workshop across the major cities in India and then we are not only the trainer, we have even conducted live training sessions in front of audience. In fact, today on Thursday we just finished one live trading session, so that was that started last Friday, and all the way today we finished that, okay? So that is another good fun, that we are not just kind of theory, we are into practical approach also. And then we do write blogs, articles, trade ideas. So you may find my blogs or market outlook that normally we publish daily on Twitter and social medias, plus trade ideas. If you're a Money Control Pro subscriber, so you can see my trade ideas that is published on daily basis, on daily trading, every trading day, okay? Then I've used to do all these things, although in currently there is no such time. So like ice skating, roller skating, bungee jumping, plus I'm like certified, three levels of certifications I have for being a scuba diver, okay? And then most of time I'm based in Mumbai, but I do got opportunity to work in other part of India like Bangalore, Chennai, short duration, and Delhi. Plus I've worked in UK as well as in USA and other part of globes like Australia, Singapore, and Sweden. I've visited for my business activities. So let me quickly move forward, and that's our agenda for today. So we're going to see why adjustment is important for us, okay? Then we're going to see some possible adjustments, okay? So if thing goes wrong, so what could be possible things that you can move here and there to control your trade? Then we're going to see a few examples, okay? Although I do have one single example, but I'll just try to find out if we can get some new scenarios. And then we're going to see best practices around adjustments, okay? And at the end, maybe 10-15 minutes, we will have a question and session. So let me move forward and let's say a big question, why to do the adjustments? Okay, like in the life today, we are adjusting, we are working from the home. Even earlier, we never heard that school from home. But nowadays, all the kids are studying from home. That is nothing, that is a sort of adjustment. Okay, so same way, if you're trading options, maybe naked options, maybe you're just long call, long pulls, or maybe a short call, short put, or maybe some strategies like iron contour, iron butterfly, or maybe any custom strategies. So in case if your trade goes wrong, then I want to do the adjustment. Okay, so if my trade is going against me, then I want to do the adjustment so that I should be able to reduce my losses. Okay, second adjustment could be possible when your trade actually goes really good. Okay, that time I want to do some kind of morphing or adjustment so that I can lock my bit of profit. Okay, maybe it may cost me some small money, but then I want to lock my profit. So these are the two different scenarios where I would love to do the adjustments. The first one is when trade is going bad, definitely adjustments are required. The second one, most of time people do call it a option morphing, or maybe you can call it a part of adjustments. Okay, so that is two typical scenarios I would love to initiate adjustments. Now let's see what are typical approaches for the adjustments. Okay, so these are typical things that you can do to adjust your trades. Okay, so let's say my trade is going wrong and I'm in loss of say 20,000. Okay, in that case my aim would be, can I reduce that 20,000 by another 10%? So that may be maybe 18,000. Okay, something that. Okay, so that would be my approach. Can I reduce my losses by another 10%, another 20%, something like that? I don't want to reduce it zero, but I want to reduce by maybe some factor. Okay, that should be my aim if I want to do the right adjustments. In case if you're assuming that from 20,000 I want to make it zero, then that it means you are doing some kind of crazy adjustments, and that can go wrong. Okay, there would be some side effects, so you have to just go step by step. As doctors, they always start with a small dose of medicine, maybe initially 5 milligram, then they will go for 10 milligram, then they will go for 20 milligram. They will directly not jump into the 50 milligram dose. Okay, so same way, if you're doing the adjustment, you have to start with the small dose and then you have to move forward. Next, if you're doing the adjustment, you have to make sure that if you're a seller of the option, then you have to make sure that you are increasing your credit. Okay, by hook or crook, you are increasing your credit. So assume that I've done some short triangle or short straddles, or maybe I'm called a butterfly, or maybe some other strategies, credit strategies. In that case, once I'm doing the adjustment, I have to make sure that by hook or crook, I'm increasing my credit. So if you're increasing your credit, it means you may get a wider range, and then that would be a sort of a easy adjustment. Okay. Next, if you buy the options, so you might have bought for 100 rupees and trade is going wrong, it means maximum you can lose 100 rupees. So you have to do the adjustment in such a way that 100 rupees cost should reduce to maybe 80 rupees, maybe 70 rupees. So you have to just do the adjustment so that the initial debit, it gets reduced. So that should be your goal. Don't try to reduce it zero. Let's go slowly. So my aim is just reduced by 10%. So initially it's 100 rupees. Then I will do the adjustment so that my cost would come down to 90 rupees. Then maybe 80 rupees, maybe 70 rupees. That will be a step-by-step approach to do your adjustment. Sometimes it does happen that we are close to the expiry, like today was the expiry day. In that case, even if I try to do some kind of adjustment from the above three, the thing is that I'll not get enough credit from the market because today is the expiry day, or we are close to the monthly expiry. Hardly 1 week is there. So if I'm doing some adjustment in my stock options or monthly Nifty options, I will not get enough credit, or maybe I'll not get enough a thing to reduce my debits. Okay, in that case, I have to buy time. So option is that you either move to the next weekly series if there is a weekly expiry. Otherwise, you can move to the next series. Sometimes it does happen that market actually went very drastically one way up. In that case, you may not be able to even resolve your problem in the next series. Then you have to go to the fall series. Okay, so that could be your approach. Or sometime people may go all the way to even December series in case of a Nifty. Okay, so you may have to think that you have to buy time so that you're not able to resolve this time. Let's take it, let's move this problem from this series to the next series, then we will take care of that. So that could be your approach. And the last could be a split your problem. Okay, so assume that that trade is giving me a big problem and I have a 20 lots of short triangle this side and that side. I may just reduce by half. So it will be 10 lot this side, 10 lot that side. That could be one approach. Or maybe I will split my strategy into two parts. One will be bullish part, one will be bearish part. And then I'll be just able to manage one part that is would be easy to manage rather than taking a big one. Okay. So these are the typical approach that you can use. So one is just reduce loss should be the aim, not reduce to zero. Okay. Second, increase your credit by hook or crook. Third, reduce your debit. Okay. Step by step. Next, buy time. That is the last option. Don't do it initially. That should be done maybe on the expiry day or maybe the last week of the expiry. Try to roll over to the next series. If next series doesn't suppose, you may even go to the fall series. And the last approach would be to split your problem. So if you're carrying a huge position, whatever problem that is giving us issue, let's reduce the size of that by half, and then it would be easy to manage a 50% of that problem. Okay. I hope until now everything is good, everyone. I'm going to move to the next slide. Okay, so next one is approach, what to do. Okay, so if you go in any books or if you read or some YouTubes or Googles, you're going to find out these are the typical approach. So first approach is if something goes up, so let's say underline goes up, not something, so in that case you have to go up. So if assume that market is going up, you took the trade non-directional or something, maybe a bearish, but market is going up, so you have to follow the market. Now in that case you have to roll up. So just understand, underlying is going up, then we have to roll up. If market is going up, I have to go up, I have to follow the market. Next approach would be that if market is going down, then I have to move down along with the market, I have to follow the market. Okay, so that should be the approach. Next, there are a lot of guys, they do a Greek based trading like delta neutral trading, so they will try to keep that delta neutralized, maybe zero. Although I personally, I don't prefer that my delta should be absolutely zero while doing the adjustment. Initially it may be zero, but while doing the adjustment, I try to make it near neutralize. Okay, not exactly neutralize, because whenever I do the absolutely neutralize, then I have to go and short something like in the money, that I don't prefer. Okay, so that's, in that case, I would prefer to do near neutralize. That would be my approach. And next would be roll over to the next series, maybe a fast series, or maybe even a yearly end series. So those could be approach for a roll over a time. And last could be don't do anything, that is not to act. In case if you have your risk is defined, in that case you would be happy that I'm happy to lose so much 100 points. In that case, you don't have to do nothing. In fact, today was a crazy day in the market when Bank Nifty started today. We have done some adjustment and our range was very narrow range, almost like 21,800 to 20,200. That was our range. Yeah. I would have been in profit range, and market was going slightly up, then started going down all the way. But then we thought, okay, I'm happy to book the profit. What is the maximum profit potential? And luckily, like market, Bank Nifty expired at nearby this level. Okay. So in that case, so today we kept, let's do nothing. I'm happy to book my profit. And we ended up booking a really good profit over here in our live trading session. Okay. So that is a typical way. So guys, is that clear? May I move forward? I hope no major questions here. Okay. Ashok, okay, let's move forward then. Let's go and see a roll-up approach. Okay, so let me go for the roll-up approach. And there could be other alternatives. Sometimes it does happen that we do add some kind of a futures more money averaging a trade. Those could be the other approaches. Okay, so let's move forward and we're gonna go for a roll-up. Okay. So let's say I have a trade and market is going up. Okay, so assume that market was say at 11,000 and now market is going all the way to 11,300. So if market is going up, then I have to move my position towards up. Okay, this could be a good move or bad move or whatever, but I have to move my position up so that I am close to the market. So that is nothing but that is known as roll up. So let's quickly see the example here. So by definition, it refers to increasing the strike of a price of an option position by closing the initial contract and opening a new contract, maybe on the same expiry, or it could be a next expiry, then that will be a roll over the time. And that is nothing but that is a roll up. So most of time we do roll up put. Okay, so let's assume that this is a payoff diagram for my short triangle. So I have took some short triangle when Nifty was around say 9,500 and we went and shorted a 9,200 a put. Okay, and then we have a shorted a call of 9,800, and we were assuming that throughout the month market would remain in between these two range.